Once there was a moonlit night there. Along the beach you could hear the waves beating, and on the beach the same waves of passion going with this young couple in an ardent embrace. All of a sudden the guy breaks away from the girl. He looks up at her and he says, "Sweetheart, tell me, am I the first man to make love to you?" And she says, "Of course. What the hell is it with you guys? You always ask the same damn ridiculous question."
Girl said last night, anything over a mouthful is wasted. I said, supposing your husband brings a guest home for dinner.
The guy picks up a broad in a bar and he gets in the car and he starts riding and he's riding and riding. He says, "Where you going?" He says, "I'm looking for a motel." The schmuck, pull into the nearest dark street. He says, "All right." He pulls into a dark street. They both get in the back of the car. He gives her a little bang. She wants another one. He gives her another bang. She wants another one. He gives her a third one. She wants more. He says, "Hey, wait a minute. I'm tired. You're wearing me out." He says, "Let me go out and get some air. Let me take a walk around the block." She says, "All right, go ahead." He gets out. He walks around the block. He runs into a friend of his. He says, "You want to do me a favor? I got an oversexed broad in the back of my car. Get in back of the car with her. Give her a couple of bangs. She'll never know the difference. It's so dark. Come back here and meet me." The friend says, "Sure." The friend gets in the car. He's giving the broad a bang. All of a sudden, a cop walks over, shines his flashlight on them. He says, "What are you doing?" The guy says, "Oh, I'm sorry, officer." He says, "But it's all right. This is my wife." The cop says, "Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know." The guy says, "I didn't know either till you shined the flash on her face."
Here's a story about a drunk that walked into a mission. He says, "Do you people save bad girls here?" The guy says, "Certainly we save bad girls." He says, "That's good. Save me one for Saturday night."
I saw a guy last night in his club. I was just standing there having a little ginger ale. And he had a black eye. I said, "How'd you get that black eye?" He said, "Well, I was kissing my old lady good night and a garter belt broke."
A guy walked into a drugstore. He said, "Let me have a 1-pound box of candy." "No, no, let me have a 2-pound box of candy. I'd help with it. Let me have them both." So the fella said, "Well, what's the idea?" He said, "Why should you have them both?" He said, "Well, I'll tell you the truth. I got a date with my chick tonight." He says, "If she lets me neck with her, I'll give her a 1-pound box of candy. If she lets me score with her, I'll give her a 2-pound box of candy." Click says, "That's great, Mac. Will you need any rubbers?" The guy says, "Nah." He says, "If it's raining, I'll stay home."
This man died, and his wife came to visit him in a funeral home, and there he was dressed up in a brown suit, and she got so insulted, and she was so mad, she said, "Are you ashamed of yourself in a brown suit? The least you could do is have a little respect, have him laid out in a blue suit, a black suit." She said, "I'm coming back in 10 minutes, and you better have him laid out in a black suit or a blue suit." She went away, she came back 10 minutes later, and there he was, laid out in a black suit. She said, "Well, at least that's a little more respectful. Tell me, what did you do? Take one of the suits off the other stiffs?" He said, "No, I switched heads." I like that story.
They had a restaurant in the jungles, and the cannibal went there to see what they had for the first time. They opened this restaurant in the jungle, and they had fried Scotchman was $2, boiled Englishman was $2, stewed spook $2, and broiled hippie was $16. The cannibal said, "My goodness, man, everything is $2, and then hippie is $16? He said, "Why is hippie so high?" Chef said, "You ever try to clean one?"
I want to mention the cannibals because they're close to us. And cannibals have a lot of sense. People just put the cannibals down here lately after they ate those missionaries up. Those missionaries wasn't no fool. They knew those cannibals didn't like broccoli and green peas and asparagus and candied yams. They don't want none of that stuff. They like kneecap, elbow, armpit, skull. I gotta dig some skull myself. And cannibals have manners and don't let nobody tell you any different. See, cannibals have good table manners. It's impolite to talk with somebody in your mouth. It was a cannibal chief and a witch doctor eating a missionary. Witch doctor said, "Chief, I'm having a ball. Chief said, well, you eating too fast.
Mrs. Riley, when she says to Mrs. Cohen, what does it look like when your husband is circumcised? Mrs. Cohen says, it's not very different. It looks like a Yul Brynner with a turtleneck sweater. You people know when a circus tent leaks? When the man on the flying trap pees. It's about a girl who died, a kurva, a prostitute. The madam is crying in her grave with another kurva. And the madam says, there goes the best kurva I ever had. The other broad says, sure, you gotta drop dead before they say one good word about it.
Then there was a couple who was crushed in the passion and embrace when the fella, his name was Charlie, he decided all of a sudden this would be the psychological moment to break off the engagement. He's been running around, let's face it, he's been shacking up with his broad for about a year, you know what I mean? Finally he says, Mary, honey, I want you to know, I mean, I think you're wonderful, I love you, I mean, your company, I mean, but as far as getting married, it's nowhere. She just keeps kissing him and holding him. He says, honey, listen to me. I mean, I'm trying to tell you, Mary. What I'm trying to say is you're like a sister to me. And all of a sudden she looks at him, my God, what a crazy home life you must have.
Now, I was a whore, but I had a quit. I can never learn the customer comes first.
A year about the lady went to the doctor. Little bit of an older lady, you know. He says, what's wrong, madam?
She says, doctor, I got a discharge.
He's all right, madam. Lay down on the table. We'll see. She lays down on the table, and he puts on the rubber finger, and he puts the finger up her condition. He's examining her. And she's going, ooh, doctor. Ooh, doctor. Ooh, I love it. Ooh, doctor, like it, doctor. He says, what is it, madam? She says, the discharge in the ear. I got it in the ear. It's like one guy saying to another guy, do you cheat on your wife? He says, who should I cheat on, my father-in-law? One guy says to another guy, you want to get screwed? He says, yeah. He says, cash me a check. What story?
There's a fella went to the doctor. He was feeling bad. He was nervous. He was upset. He didn't know what was wrong with him. He got to the doctor's office. So the doctor wasn't there, so the nurse looked at him. He was shaking there, sitting, trembling. She said, well, maybe I can help you. And so he explained that he was young and he'd never had an affair ever in his life. He's never before, and he had his body, his physical thing. He was just upset and shaking and eyes twitching. Had that thing. So the nurse said, well, I understand. Come on here in the office with me. So she took him there in the office and shut the door and knocked over a few medicine bottles. Some pills fell on the floor in the process. This guy left. About 4 or 5 weeks later, he had that same feeling on him again. He went to the doctor's office, but this time the doctor was there, so the doctor took him inside and explained his condition to the doctor. Doc, it's the first time I never had, and I never before in my life had. The doctor said, well, look here, you take these pills here, and that'll be $5. He said, well, doctor, it's all the same to you. I'd like to get that $20 treatment again.
I have a story for you about a drunk who goes into a bar, he orders a double scotch. One for everybody, one for himself, and one for the bartender. A little while later, he repeats the order. Bartender gives him a tab for $185. He can't pay, so the bartender throws him out. Next day, he comes back, the bartender looks at him, he says, don't tell me. He says, you want a drink for everybody in the house? And one for me, too. The guy says, no, not you. You get too nasty when you drink.
There was a husband. He was watching his flat-chested wife put a bra on. He said, what'd you buy that for? You ain't got nothing to put in it. She said, well, you wear jogging shorts, don't you?
I went to the food fair today. You ever go to the food fair? Woman grabs me. She says, you do your own shopping? It's a real nut. Picks up a chicken, starts to smell it. Left, right, front, back, all around, she's smelling the chicken. She says to the butcher, this chicken stinks. The butcher looked at her, he said, madam, could you pass a test like that?
Question and a toast. How does a French girl hold her liquor? By the ears.
Guy walks into the bar here the other day. He walks up to the bartender and says, "Pardon me, do you know how to make a fruit cordial?" The bartender says, "Be nice to him."
Here's another man. Walks in the bedroom. He knows his wife is cheating. He's, "I know you got a guy here, and if I grab him, I will really give him. But oh boy." And he opens the closet doors. He can't find him. Goes in the bathroom, pulls across the shower curtain. There's a man stark naked. He says, "There you are." He says, "What do you want from me? I came to vote." And he's pulling the lever. I have his husband come down with his wife and his baby doll. Tonight I get sex up and different. So what could be different? He says, "Listen, you get in the bed, you put your back to me, I'll put my back to you." She's stupid, how are you gonna reach? I forgot to tell you I invited another couple.
Now what would you like to do?
I want to be weighed.
All right, here's a scale. 107 pounds. Hey, how about going for a ride on the whip?
I want to get weighed.
Well, how about the scenic railway?
I want to be weighed.
All right, forget it. I'll take you home. What's the matter? Aren't you having a good time?
No, wowsy.
Then came the courthouse. I walked in. I looked up. I faced the judge. The judge said, "Do you work?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Where do you work?" I said, "Oh, here and there." He said, "What do you do?" I said, "Oh, this and that." He said, "Well, when do you work?" I said, "Now and then." He said, "All right, take him away." I said, "Wait a minute, Judge. When are you going to let me out?" He said, "Sooner or later."
You seen that sign out in front of Big Bill and said, "Join the Navy and see the world"? There was a guy who walked up, he saw that sign. He said, "That's a good idea. I ain't doing nothing. I ain't had a job in a year. I'll join the Navy." So he joined the Navy. And in January, our friend, this sailor, he shot a polar bear. In February, he danced with a hula girl. In March, the doctor told the sailor he should have danced with the polar bear and shot the hula girl.
It ain't but one king of the jungle, and that's the lion. I was out in the jungle one day, and the big lion was walking through the jungle, and he knew that he was the king, and he run up on a snake crawling in the grass, and he grabbed the snake by the tail and said, "Who's the king of the jungle?" The snake said, "You are, Mr. Lion, you are. Just turn me loose and I'll crawl away." And then he went on down a little bit further, and he grabbed the eagle by the tail and said, "Who's the king of the jungle?" The eagle said, "You are, Mr. Lion, you are. Just turn me loose and I'll fly away." Go on down a little bit further, he grabs a great big elephant. The elephant grabs him back, wraps his trunk around his neck and throws him down and starts choking him and stomping him. And the lion broke it loose and said, "You didn't have to be so nasty just because you didn't know the answer."
Fella invited a girl to a lamb dinner. So she wasn't too... She know too much about going. She said, "What is a lamb dinner?" He said, "That's six martinis and a piece of you." Thank you, darling. That's a lady knows what it is. It's E-W-E. A lot of folks don't even know what a U is. They don't know about the farm. When I was in the service, we were overseas, and we were passing by this farm, and there was a sheep stuck in the fence. We were marching by, and one soldier looked over and said, "I sure wish that was Elizabeth." Another soldier said, "I sure wish it was Gladys." Another soldier said, "I sure wish it was Knight." She said, "Bring me a Long Island duck." Butcher gave her a duck and she stuck her finger in the duck and smelled it. She said, "Man, this is a Michigan duck." Butcher gave her another duck. So she stuck her finger in there and she said, "Man, this is a Nebraska duck." She gave her another duck and she stuck her finger in. She said, "Now this is a Long Island duck." She said, "You must be new here, aren't you, Butcher?" He said, "Yes, ma'am, I started yesterday." She said, "Well, where are you from?" Butcher lowered his pants and bent over and said, "You tell me."
In Central Park with a guy was making love to a girl. He was on the top and the cop walks over and taps the guy on his shoulder. He says, "I'm next." Guy looks up at the cop. He says, "I never made it with a cop before."
"I know, baby. I was married to a grip. I divorced him because he was indifferent. In fact, I didn't know which way to turn, baby. And you know, I don't drink and I don't like libation. I was so stoned last night, I walked in the men's room by mistake. Let's see. Four guys were standing with their backs to me. I thought they were praying. Do I know what the hell they were doing?"
hear about the broad went to the doctor. She says, oh, doc, something's in my stomach. Something's in my stomach. He takes an x-ray. He sees a little mouse in her stomach. He says, how did it get in there? She says, my pussy fell asleep. True.
I remember when the elevator door was about to close. Just got into the elevator. As I did, my elbow hit a lady in the breast. And I said, gee, miss, I'm awful sorry. Please forgive me. I said, you know something? If your heart is as soft as your breast, you must be a wonderful person. She said, you know something? If your rotten is as hard as your elbow, I'm in room 324.